So my name is Georgios Markakis. I'm the project manager for BBV. I'm working in the Curzon Approach Viaducts. We are in the Birmingham city center, and right behind us is Lawley Middleway Viaduct, what we call phase one, which is 112 meters long, which we recently launched over the road during 5 nights. Phase one, which is part of the 185 meter long Lawley Middleway Viaduct. Curzon Approach is practically a 1 mile continuous viaduct, which we split in 5 assets. The first being Dudderstone. Then we have Curzon 1. We have Curzon 2, which is the Warren Truss 150 meter bridge. We have Curzon 3, which is a 340 meter concrete viaduct. So Lawley Middleway is between Curzon 3 and Curzon 2 bridges. Ultimately, when everything has been completed, Curzon Approach Viaduct will take the trains from Bromford Tunnel and Bosworth Heath area up to the city centre and will ultimately connect to the new station which is currently being built. We had to construct part of Lawley Middleway, what we call phase one, over one of the busiest roads of Birmingham. Therefore, we couldn't close the road for the period that required for the asset to be constructed. The solution we came up with is to fabricate, assemble the structure offline. We built an encapsulation over it, and then we welded the pieces in position, constructed a series of temporary works relating with the launching, and then launched it over the road during a series of night closures, thus minimizing disruption. The first night was purely a rotation. We brought the SPMTs, self-propelled modular transporter, a platform on wheels, has a lot of maneuverability, the wheels turned 360. It's a very clever system, and you will see a lot of bridges have been launched using them. For example, Aston was launched using SPMTs that carry the bridge in its final position. We jacked up the bridge, placed it on top of the SPMTs and rotated the bridge. That on itself was a very tricky operation because obviously we had to align the bridge properly. After that, one of the SPMTs moved away as we rested the structure on top of the jacking systems. And then the SPMT on the back is practically moving and pushing the structure, where what we call a skidding system pulls the structure. And these systems pick up the structure, they move it 6 meters, and then they drop it on a system we have on the front called mega jacks, and it acts as a passive support. Then they drop it there, they transfer the load, and then they jack down, move back, pick up the structure again, and do the same thing, until we reach the other side of the road where we have another skidding shoe system, and they work in parallel. So the skidding shoe systems move on rails back and forth. We lubricate them to allow the skidding shoe system to minimize the friction. The skidding shoes are moved back and forth with a jack, which is expanding and contracting, and hence they're able to move. So as soon as the structure reaches the other side of the road and rests on top of the skidding beam which we have on that side, then the SPMT on the back gets removed and disassembled, and the two skidding systems work in tandem until they get the structure into position. The plan was to launch 12 meters every night, but because we're able to optimize the whole operation, we achieved 24 meters per night. Being able to finish the structure ahead of schedule was a great benefit for everybody, for our stakeholders and businesses who were able to minimize the disruption that they experienced. We now have the bridge in position, so we're now preparing to the next stages. One of them is obviously the removal of the temporary works, such as temporary bracing or the launching equipment. Some of them are obviously building the next phases of Lawley. We're constructing piers, which are the remaining Curzon piers, which we couldn't construct before due to the bridge being assembled in the location that they were supposed to be. For everybody in the team, it's a great achievement. Everybody is elated for what we achieved, and seeing all the hard work and planning that went ahead the last couple of years materialize. So we now can use this as a benchmark and utilize the lessons learned from here to implement it for the future launching schemes that we have.